The Parsha have told us that we're going to begin this week to read. So the Torah begins with the following pasuk. B'yelad toldos Yitzhak ben Avram, Avram holdeth Yitzhak. The Torah indicates the lineage, the progeny of Yitzhak, the son of Avram. Avram gave birth to Yitzhak. Of course, what's striking immediately is the language of toldos. A language that appears a number of times in Sefer Bereishis, as a matter of fact, a fair number of times in Sefer Bereishis. In the previous Parsha of Chayisara, at the very end, the Torah there also tells us, Ve'ela told us Yishmael ben Avram. The Torah relates the progeny, the children of Yishmael, the son of Avram, and then the Torah proceeds to list the names of those children. Ve'ela Shmos b'nei Yisrael b'shmosam b'soldosam b'chor Yishmael nevoyos v'kedor v'ad be'el u'mifsam u'mishma v'duma u'masa chadad v'seimu yetur nafish v'kedma. So we have a rather lengthy list of the children of Yishmael, and then the Torah tells us the lifespan of Yishmael, and finally it ends v'yishkenu mechavila atshura she'al p'nei mitzrayim bo'acha atshura al p'nei kol echav nafal. The Torah 10 tells us that these children apparently were rather successful and they, in effect, obviously conquered a fair amount of territory and they built empires that the Torah goes on to describe. A similar phenomena we also find, not only with reference to Yishmael, but we find a similar phenomena with reference to Esav. The Torah, at the end of Parshas Vayishlach, devotes a fair amount of time to this as well. In Perek Lamed Vav, the Torah says, Ve'ela told us Esav hu Edom. These are the progeny of Esav. And then we have a list of Esav's wives in Pasuk Beis, Oda bas Ilun Achiti, Olivama basana bas Sivun Achivi. And the Torah then goes on at great length to describe the toldos of Esav. The children of Esav, Eliphaz, Reuel, the children of Eliphaz, and on. Many psukim are devoted to describing the progeny of Esav. And not only are the progeny of Esav described, but the Torah then tells us at the end of Vayishlach, we even have a list of kings who ruled in Edom, kings and chieftains. So it's very striking. When we read of the toldos of Yishmael and Esav, there the Torah at great length describes their progeny, the continuity, biological continuity, if you will, of these two families, of the empires that they built and conquered, of the territorial hold, and yet, in stark contrast, stands the psukim that we begin to read in this week's Parsha. Ve'ela toldos Yitzhak ben Avram, Avram holdeth Yitzhak. And yet, we do not find that the Torah subsequently prevents us, in effect, from dealing with the personalities that unfold and emanate. We don't have what we have with Yishmael and Esav, biological progeny after progeny. But here the Torah goes on to describe, if you will, all the episodes that relate to the personalities that are involved, the avos. And of course, we ask ourselves the question, how does one explain the distinction between Yishmael and Esav on the one hand and the toldos of Yitzhak ben Avram and Yaakov on the other hand? And the answer is fairly evident. The word toldos vis-a-vis Yishmael and Esav refers primarily to biological continuity. When the Torah speaks of Yishmael, it says, Hinei Yifresi also, Birbesi also, Hashem has blessed him, Hashem has made him fruitful, and Hashem has multiplied him exceedingly. And that's the language that's found commonly vis-a-vis Yishmael and Esav. However, here, interestingly enough, the Torah uses a different expression. Ve'ela told us Yitzhak ben Avram, and then the Hifil form is used, Avram holdeth Yitzchak. A similar expression is found later on in the Torah at the end of Sefer Bereishis, with reference to the grandchildren of Yosef. There it speaks of children and grandchildren, Sheyuldu al-Birke Yosef. In other words, over and above the biological dimension that also exists vis-a-vis Yitzhak and Yaakov, and that's embedded in the language at the beginning of this week's Pasha, Ela told Yitzhak and Avram, there's also a mandate of Holid. There's a spiritual mandate to inculcate values, to imbue our children with Amunah, with Chesed, with Mesiras Nefesh, and this of course is strikingly different than that which we find vis-a-vis Esav and Yishmael. There, Esav and Yishmael seemingly are not affected by the problems of Tzar Gidul Banim. Their families multiply, grow with an ease and a kind of facility. On the contrary, Yaakov, Yitzchak, seem to be beleaguered, engulfed by Tzaros. And there are many Mamari Chazal that indicate this. Apparently, what the Torah is trying to tell us is that a fundamental distinction between the lives of Yishmael and Esav and the lives of Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov is the following. Their lives are marked by biological continuity, those of Yishmael and Esav, of colossal empires, built in a seemingly facile and unencumbered fashion. No crisis, no trauma, no Tzar Gidul Banim. On the other hand, the lives of Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov are the very antithesis. It's not simply a toldos representing biological continuity, but obviously we're talking about Yisurim, we're talking about crisis, we're talking about trauma, and of course this represents, in many respects, the greatness of Klal Yisrael. The greatness of Klal Yisrael is, as the Pasuk in Shir HaShirim says, Kishoshana ben hachochim, kein rayosi ben habonos. A shoshana, of course, is a rose, a soft-petaled flower, and yet that tender soft-petaled flower, essentially, is our model, because it grows among kotzim bedarderanim, among thorns and thistles. And dafka, in that kind of an environment, that's where it begins to blossom and develop. Chazal say, Baklal Yisrael, Vayishom l'goy gadol, dafka in Mitzrayim, we became a great nation. Dafka in Mitzrayim, which many have interpreted to mean Bein HaMitzarim, between the straits, there we emerge with a real physiognomy. And all its real growth and maturity comes out of suffering and pain, both physical and psychologically. The Kor HaBarzel is the key. And that's the Kor HaBarzel that Klal Yisrael underwent in Mitzrayim and elsewhere throughout our history. And that's a very significant lesson that we have to learn. In other words, if we compare the lives of Avraham, Yitzchak, Yaakov with those of Yishmael, Esav, it's a very stark contrast. Their toldos are toldos of biological continuity. Our toldos are based on Holid, Avram Holid es Yitzchak, Yuldu Abirke Yosef, lives that are founded upon Mesiras Nefesh, Emuna, values Chesed, only with constant jockeying and constant wrestling and constant Yisurin. That's where Klal Yisrael emerged. So even though it would seem to be a more difficult kind of lifestyle, but ultimately it was one that led to the Netzach of Klal Yisrael, Netzach Yisrael lo Yishaker, unlike the lives that are modeled by Yishmael and Esav.